to this 30 minutes class of learning Swahili. Swahili sometimes is called Kiswahili, K-I-S-W-A-H-I-L-I. So if you say Kiswahili, you're trying to emphasize that it is a language. Otherwise, it is Swahili. Swahili is a language spoken in different countries in Africa. Not very many of them speak Swahili that fluent, but there are some countries like Tanzania that have contributed a lot to the development of Swahili. In only 30 minutes, I may not teach everything there is about Swahili. Of course, I can't. I have just picked a few words that we use in our everyday life, and words that I also use a lot here at the studio because I do a Zipora Mesesi Swahili program. Just before I started to do this class, I said a word that actually is supposed to be a sentence. I said, he is eating. In Swahili, we would say, ana kula. And we write it, ana kula. It is one word, but actually in Swahili, it's already a full sentence. I will come back to one word full sentence later on. For now, I am just going to give a few words that we use every day. One is when someone comes to you or you want to tell them to come, come. In Swahili, we say, kuja. Also, it is okay to say njoo. So, if you want to tell someone to come, in Swahili we say kuja or njoo. So, if you want them to come here, here we say hapa, H-A-P-A. So if here is hapa, then if you want to tell someone, come here, you will say kuja hapa, and that's perfect, or you say njoo hapa. Those two are okay. Now, when you meet someone, of course, you always want to know their name. Name. In Swahili is jina. So if you want to ask someone, what is your name? You will say, jina lako nani. That is a long sentence, jina lako ni nani. So jina is the name, lako is you are talking to that person, your name, Ni is you want to know which name is it? And nan is like putting a question mark. So if you say jina lako ni nani, you are saying in English, what is your name? If you want to talk about the I, that's the part of the body. In Swahili, we say jicho. One eye. If you're talking about the two eyes, we say macho. So macho is eyes. Mouth. Mdomo. Mouth. Mdomo. Tooth. We say jino. That's one. If we are talking about teeth, we say meno. So one tooth is jino. You're talking about teeth. It's meno. There is a word I love to use a lot in my program when I say Zipora Mesesi Swahili Show, then I say karibu. Many friends ask me, why do you keep repeating the name karibu? K-A-R-I-B-U. Karibu can mean two things. It can mean welcome, and that's what it means when I use it in my program, welcome to my program. Or you can again use karibu to mean near or close to. So I will give an example. Table. Table in Swahili is meza. So I come to the studio and Nikki will ask me, where is your pen? And my pen is near the table. So when I say karibu meza, my pen is close to the table, that is a different meaning from when I say welcome, karibu to my program. So karibu, depending on how you use it, can mean welcome and is used a lot to welcome guests to your house or to welcome people to your program, or if someone has done you a favor and you want to appreciate, you can say karibu. At the same time, it can mean you are talking about something close to. Back to parts of our body. Nose. in English. In Swahili is pua. It's P-U-A, pua. Finger. In Swahili is kidole. That's one finger. But if we are talking about two fingers, in Swahili it's vidole. Two fingers or three fingers or all fingers is vidole. Hair. In Swahili, it's nywele. Nywele. Fire. In Swahili, it's moto. Water. In Swahili, it's maji. Maji. Eat. Kula. So when you want to tell someone eat, you just say kula. And when we eat food. And food in Swahili is chakula. Chakula. So if you want to say eat food, you will say kula chakula. I said come is kuja. Now go. Go is enda. Sometimes too, when you are talking about a person and you're talking to the person, you may use the word nenda. Both of them are okay. Enda or nenda. Home. Home is nyumbani. 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 Home. So if you want to tell someone, go home, you will tell them, enda nyumbani or nenda nyumbani. Child. child is mtoto. 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 My. Something that belongs to you, or the child belongs to you, we say angu. But when it is a child, because it's a person, we say, if you want to say in English, my child, we say mtoto wangu. So mtoto is a child and my is angu, but because it's a person, we say wangu, mtoto wangu. Work. Work in Swahili is kazi. Kazi. So if enda is to go, then when you say in English, I am going to work, you say in Swahili, na enda kazi. I'm going to work. If you're talking about your work, that is in English, my work, you will say kazi yangu. Kazi yangu. My work. Kazi is work. Yangu is my. But we have to start with kazi. So you say kazi yangu. Dad. Dad in Swahili is baba. Baba. So if you want to say my dad, then you say baba yangu. Baba yangu. And spoon. Spoon in Swahili is kijiko. Kijiko. If there are more spoons, we say vijiko. Spoons is vijiko. So using those few words that I have explained the meaning, I will quickly show a one sentence word in Swahili that includes most of the parts of the words I have just explained. So if we want to say, I am going, In Swahili, just one word will be a complete sentence. It will be ninaenda. Ninaenda. That is me. Ni here stands for me. And then na is right now. It stands for the time. And end, or enda, is the act of going. So to make a difference, you are talking here that I am going. If it is you who is going, we will say unaenda. That is, you are going. If it is a third person, we will say anaenda. If it is many people, but it is them and you are not included, you will say wanaenda. So I am going, ninaenda. You are going, unaenda. He or she is going, someone else, we will say anaenda. And then when it's many people, but you are not included, then you will say wanaenda. But if you are amongst the people who are going, that is, we are going, you will say tunaenda. So I am going, ninaenda. You are going, unaenda. She or he is going, anaenda. They are going, wanaenda. They are going and I'm also among them. That is, we are going. Then you say tunaenda. So this part here, ni, is what makes one know you are talking about yourself. And when this part, oo, is put there, you know we are talking about you. And when you say at the start, it means another person is the one going. And this section, wa, shows you that it's them that are going, or they are many. And when you use two, it means that I am amongst them that are going. Now, just to differentiate time, because this was something that is going on now, if it was tomorrow, if it is tomorrow, instead of saying ninaenda, when you say I will go, you will say nitaenda. So this section of ta shows that it's future, it's tomorrow, or in a few hours' time. And when you are saying you will go, you will say utaenda. When you want to say he or she will go, you will say ataenda. And when you want to talk about many people that are going, but you are not included, you will say wataenda. and so ta 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 makes the difference that it's future. And if you're going to be part of the group that is going, you will say to ta and. So the section 2 shows that I am among them, and ta represents the time, its future. And enda is the act of going. Because of time, I will quickly go through a few other words that we use in everyday life. Like here at the television station, we have different programs. So those different programs when it is one program, we say kipindi. Kipindi, one program or one show. If there are many shows, we say many programs or shows. We'll say vipindi. Vipindi. If you want someone to run, we say kimbia, 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 run. You want them to run fast. Fast, we say haraka, haraka, fast, haraka. You want them to learn or do something slow, we use two words together, pole, pole. Now that word pole, pole, sometimes also can be used as one word that means sorry. So when you meet someone who, for instance, has lost a loved one and you want to tell them, I'm sorry to hear you, your mother passed away. In Swahili, just one word without saying too much. If you just say the word pole, and usually depending on how you say it, it says everything when you use the word pole when someone is grieving and you want to tell them, I'm sorry or I feel for you. It's not only for grieving. If I wrong you and I want to apologize, we also use pole to show that we are sorry. And one word I don't like to forget because I work on it every day is wait. Zipporah is working on her wait. In Swahili is uzito. And so if you want to tell me to reduce my weight, is punguza, that is reduce, uzito, weight. Until next time, when I'll have time again to teach a few Swahili words. If you can't remember any word, if you wrong someone, please tell them pole. Thank you.